This video, I'll attempt to quickly explain the new collision filtering system in EasyBallistics 1.3. Collision filter can be used to conditionally turn on or off collisions between the bullet and some specific actor. So let's imagine a usage case for this. So let's say you want to disable friendly fire. So let's imagine one of these targets is a friendly and you want bullets to just pass through him. Even though it's same type, it's same collision settings as other ones. So let's start by opening the target blueprint. And we are going to change collision settings first, and namely under collision presets, we're going to turn this into custom and responses to bullet as we set them in one of the previous tutorials. I'm now going to change it to overlap. Now, when set to block, the collision filter doesn't apply. The bullet always hits. When it's to ignore, it of course never hits. But when it's set to overlap, the collision filter comes into play. So I'm going to set it to overlap, and this will be set in the target blueprint, so all the targets will be affected. So now, if we try to play the game, as you can see, not much has changed. The collisions still happen. So now let's get to the interesting part. Let's open the blueprint and under functions, let's click override and let's override the collision filter. And now we have a custom function that by default doesn't have any nodes and returns false. And if we play the game now, as you can see, suddenly bullets pass straight through the target. However, for terrain or other objects that still have collision set to block, they still happen. However, this is not what we are trying to achieve. What are we trying to do is to make only some of the targets transparent to bullets. So let's imagine this one is friendly and the other ones are not. So let's open this actor. Let's go all the way down to actor, expand this, and let's add a gameplay tag. And let's call this one, I don't know, good. Yeah. And let's go back to our override. And let's break out the hit result. And let's check which actor we are about to hit and see if it has some specific tag, namely if it's tagged as good. Excuse me. Like this. And we are going to invert this result because we want targets that are not tagged as good to receive hits. So let's plug this result as a return node, compile, and see if it works. Now, this one is not tagged, and as you can see, bots hit it. This one is tagged, and bots pass right through him. Simple as that. Of course, you can get more creative than that. You can check, for instance, how old the actor is to prevent spawn camping, or to create some sort of safe zone that only works for one team but not the other, and so on.